Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Street Smile Solutions, streetsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about the difference between self-ligating, aka Damon braces, versus traditional braces, which are held on with a little rubber tie. So I have a picture here of the self-ligating. I'm pretty sure most of you know what the traditional braces look like. The wire just sits in the bracket and there's a little rubber tie that goes over it that's often in different colors. So benefits of self-ligating are that you actually need, it depends on the case. If you have a crowding case, you know, and not a spacing case, then it might be quicker to do self-ligating brackets. But most doctors usually charge extra for self-ligating brackets. So the question to me is, what's your difference between your self-ligating price brackets and your Invisalign price? Because often it's actually higher or the same. I've always charged an extra probably $500 to $1,000 for self-ligating brackets because they're significantly more expensive for the doctor to buy, like two, three, four, five times more expensive per bracket. They're just very sophisticated. Sometimes doctors will charge the same. So just questions to ask. The benefits, if you have a crowding case, if you have a spacing case, there's no benefits. So there's no sense because, especially if you have to pay more, right? You don't have to pay more than no. But if you have a crowding case, it will save you appointments. So normal appointments when you're in the initial phase, which is the leveling and aligning stage of braces, which is the initial stage when you're just undoing all the crowding. If you have self-ligating brackets, you may only need to come in like a couple times in the first year, you know, like maybe every 2 to 3 months as opposed to every 6 to 8 weeks or 4 to 6 weeks. So it will save you a ton of time. They can put a slightly bigger wire in. They can just close the little trap door. So the difference is that the wire sits in this little bracket, which has a trap door, which is snapped down over it. So a regular rubber tie or an O-ring that holds the wire in the bracket that has to be changed, it will degrade over time. So its tightness, you know, degrades and dissipates. So you have to get it changed. It only really lasts up to maybe, I would say, 6 to 8 weeks. Whereas the little trap door, if you put a nice big heavy wire in and slap that trap door down, you're good for a few months. So less appointments, probably more efficient, assuming your doctor puts the brackets on correctly, if you're a crowding case. Now, if you're a spacing case, there's no benefit because you're gonna need power chains, which are rubber ties anyways, that are all connected. So that's pretty much what I have to say. So they're great. I mean, if you're really, really not wanting, so first of all, let me circle back to one of the things that I preface, which is in the right hands with an educated doctor who knows what he's doing. And in residency, you don't learn a lot about Invisalign. You learn a lot about braces, but you don't learn a lot about Invisalign, or at least we didn't when we went there. We weren't even really allowed to do it. So it's fundamentally the same thing, same principles, but a different way of getting what you want, right? So in my hands, I can do everything with Invisalign. There's no case I can't do with Invisalign. Sometimes I can do things faster with braces or more efficiently or more predictably, but it doesn't mean I can't do it, right? Some cases I can do faster with Invisalign. But I'm also very confident and very experienced. Not all orthodontists are very experienced with Invisalign. Of course, you can tell by looking at where they are in the Invisalign doctor locator. It does not mean that they're a bad doctor if they don't do a ton of Invisalign. They might be a great doctor. They just don't do a lot of plastic. It's one of those things, if you're fully committing to working with plastic, you're gonna wanna do more plastic and less braces, because once you love doing it, you love doing it. So, but anyways, what I was basically saying was that, you know, you gotta check out the prices. You gotta think about your own experience. If you really don't like the idea of having plastic in your mouth, and some people don't, they would rather have wires and brackets, because especially if you're a big snacker or a big coffee sipper throughout the day, the trays may not work for you. You may not like that. It's a very much a change of lifestyle. And with traditional brackets, you can eat whatever, not whatever you want. You can't eat hard and crunchy things, but you can at least drink whatever you want. And for some people, that will work better. So anyways, just things to think about. I do like self-ligating brackets. They are significantly more expensive. But in the right case, it will save you time if you are wanting brackets and wires. All right, thanks so much.